NBC2 First Alert Hurricane Week continues. I'm anchor Peter Bush live in Charlotte County tonight. We're at the Village of Holiday Lake Community, which had two natural disasters last year. First, a hurricane in January, and then, of course, first a tornado in January, and then, of course, Hurricane Ian, which left nothing but the laundry room on this lot. And now we wanted to check in and see how they're recovering, and with the peak of hurricane season just a month away, how they're preparing.
She's going for my weeds, the million weeds.
Denise White is what you would call a very good stepdaughter. On this brutally hot day,
I can't believe you've done all this.
Oh, she's pulling weeds in her stepmom's yard and still finding debris from Hurricane Ian along the way.
She just got siding fixed and her roof done, and that's just recently. We've had blue tarps.
Hurricane Ian made its second landfall right near this community with sustained winds of 145 miles per hour. There were about 550 homes in this community, but those winds wiped out about 30% of them.
We lost the lanai, we lost the front porch, the back part of the house, the roof came up on the corner.
All that damage, and Chris Seals considers herself lucky that her house is already put back together. Her lesson learned from Ian is to be prepared.
I have my hurricane box all packed and ready to go with snacks and water and battery-operated fans because the power was out for 2.5 weeks here.
And after twin national disasters last year, some residents in the Village of Holiday Lake feel like they're in the middle of another storm. Florida's insurance crisis.
A lot of people have been canceled, and they're not able to get new insurance. So that's going to be an issue for mobile homes especially.
But Denise White is confident in the future of her community.
But we will recover. We've been pretty strong. People have band together, Florida strong, and I think it's really been true.
October. Denise's optimism seems to be warranted because if you look around the community, there is a clear difference between the homes that were built 30, 40 years ago and the ones in the past 15 to 20 years. The ones that were recently built, relatively speaking, fared pretty well and had minimal damage from Hurricane Ian. So it just goes to show that as we improve our building codes and strength of roofs and windows, that even communities, you know, like this, that don't have the, you know, that are built on top of, you know, mobile homes that don't have really as much foundation as some other homes, they can do fine during hurricanes. Kelly?